Hello, welcome to the QuickerSim CFD Toolbox for Matlab, tutorial number 22. In this tutorial, we will show you a simple example how to perform automatic shape optimization coupled with CFD solver. It is strongly advised that you go through two introductory tutorials first. Tutorial number 6 on geometry deformation and tutorial number 13 on flow past NACA 0012 laminar profile. To give you an idea what we want to do today, what we have is a standard NACA 0012 profile and we want to deform its ending so that the ratio of lift to drag is maximized. We can tilt it upwards or downwards. Obviously, we will be turning it downwards, and if we turn it too much, the drag increases too much, but lift also increases, and we want to find the optimal place for that. The whole optimization procedure is actually a code that consists of two files. There's an external file that's called here optimization example, where we just set the optimization bounds. The value of alpha is actually the translation of the central point of the trailing edge, and we will impose various translations on our original geometry. The new thing here is that our CFD solution that used to be the main file actually is being turned into a function that's called CFD solver, and this function is being called in the optimization function used in MATLAB. There are lots of optimization functions available in more advanced toolboxes like optimization toolbox and so on. In order for everybody to have the access to those tutorials, we are using a basic built-in function in MATLAB that's called fmin_bounded, and it will be simply performing one parameter search within the specified bounds and with limitation of 50 iterations. OptimSet parameter actually can be passed with few other options. For instance, the maximum change between two optimization steps and so on. Our optimization algorithm will actually always want to minimize our objective function. Hence, as you see in the solver later on, we will denote our objective function as minus lift to drag. Okay, so let's go back to the CFD solver for now. As I already told, that's a modification of tutorial number 13, and we read the basic mesh, we start deforming it using the radial basis functions, while the deformation is passed from the outside as the optimization parameter. You can see that's the main argument in here. Now the mesh is deformed, it's being displayed, extra parameters are defined, some under relaxation parameter that has already been discussed in other tutorials. That's the main iterative loop. Some post-processing of data is dumped, we do not want to see that at the moment, but the most important thing is the evaluation of our objective function. So obviously we still need to calculate the forces, force coefficients, and this is our objective function. This is the ratio of lift over drag. After the objective function has been evaluated, we also display its value and we do some extra saving. We can export our results to Gmesh in forms of pressure and velocity, and we also save our design parameters into a text file. When performing an optimization loop, it is strongly advised that you save the intermediate steps as they can serve as new input parameters for new optimization loops if the first optimization cycle doesn't converge to what we want. Before we begin our optimization procedure, it is also recommended that you check that your basic CFD solver performs as you wish. So we execute it as a function. And let's say we want to deform as minus 0.05. Yes, and the convergence process begins. Let's have a look at our geometry. There it goes. As you can see, the mesh is being deformed slightly to the bottom. Okay, we can terminate the procedure and proceed to the whole optimization loop. We simply move to the optimization example and perform the whole script. Let's run it. The simulations will really take a while because actually we will be required to do like 10 simulations and each has to converge to the level of 10 to minus 6. So you need a little bit of patience and we will just present you the final results. So it looks like the following. So that's how the optimization airfoil would look like. And the convergence history is the following in our simulations. That's the number of the simulation performed by the optimization algorithm. And the orange line represents what value of alpha has been tested in the simulation. And the blue line represents what's the live to drag ratio. So you can see that after 6 iteration, it already flats out and we get like something above 9. And the alpha value, something like minus 0.6. This is like 23% improvement from the initial case when alpha is equal 0. Okay, so that concludes this tutorial. We hope that you enjoyed that. Please visit our website quickersim.com, check out other tutorials and drop us a comment. See you next time.